stars in style, let's dance for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies. Hoping for the best, but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young, or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we never say never. Sitting in a sandpit, life is a short trip. The music's for the sad man. Can you imagine when this race is won? Turn our golden faces into the sun. Praising our leaders, we're getting in tune. The music's played by the madman. Forever young, I want to be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever, 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 forever young. I want to be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever young. Some are like water, some are like the heat. Some are a melody and some are the beat. Sooner or later they all will be gone. Why don't they stay young? It's a hard to get old without a cause. I don't want to perish like a fading rose. Youth like diamonds in the sun, and diamonds are forever.
Harrods is quite a popular shop. There's people queuing up to get inside. They also have dress codes for those that want to go shopping in there. They won't allow people in shorts and things like that to go into the shop. You have to dress quite smartly just to even get in. I think this summer there was an incident where over here we've got a thing called a national lottery system now, and it's on, actually on a Saturday, you can buy a ticket for £1 and you enter six numbers into the National Lottery, and if all your six numbers come up, you get a share of the jackpot. Well, the jackpot can be anything between sort of £5 million and £20 million. one of the jackpot winners, I think she won something like £10 million, and she decided to come on a shopping trip to Harrods, and she just picked up a cheque for £10 million, and because she wasn't dressed correctly, they wouldn't let her into the shop. So that was that was their loss. She didn't buy anything in there. Some of the street vendors in London here have been known to take advantage of tourists. So you're probably better advised to buy things from the shops rather than off the street, unless you can get a good price. I know in the past there's been things in our newspapers about some of the tourists paying £5 for a tin of Coke in the middle of summer when it's really warm. Obviously the vendor was rubbing his hands there, because it can buy them for about 30p. If you have a drink in a bar, drinks in a bar for a pint, I don't know whether you have measures of pints, but for a pint you should pay no more than about £2 in a bar, although the average price is about £1.70. If you go into a nightclub, the entrance fee just to get into some of the nightclubs, especially in London, can be anything between £7 and £25. It's £25 to get into Stringfellas. If you go into a burger bar, obviously we've got the like McDonald's and Burger King, they're reasonably priced, and they're ranging between sort of 70p and £2 or £3 for a burger meal, like sort of thing. But there is other establishments, like we've just across from Marble Arch, which is just in front of us here, but just across the other side is Planet Hollywood, and you can queue up to get into Planet Hollywood because it's a popular place to get into, and that's a little bit more expensive, so you pay something like £5 for a burger in there. There's also the Hard Rock Cafe, which is more or less the same sort of thing. That's down to Museum.
It was built in 1863, and it came from Paddington to Farringdon here. 1863, London has the oldest underground station. It's actually a statue of Angel of Charity, it's meant to be, but a lot of people say it's the god of love, Eros, the god of love, because he's meant to be having a bow and arrow and shooting love down from him. but in fact it's the Angel of Charity dedicated to Lord Shaftesbury. We came down Shaftesbury Avenue, and he did lots for poor people in the area. Look at all these signs here in front of you, Piccadilly Circus. If we were to go to the left, there's Regent Street, a fabulous street, Regent Street. But here, Piccadilly Circus, these signs, one sign costs £750,000 for 4 months. There won't be any buses up there, so maybe you could be there at about quarter to 11.
Okay. Thank you.
Misschien wel, maar... Mooi
and Charles both had
their offices. Praat dus even.
Diana and Charles split and then Diana...
It's coming, running coming too.
Charles is still here in St. James's Palace. This whole street, of course, was shut for Diana's whole week when she was lying here in St. James's Chapel. Everybody else just said, keep quiet, this is a place of mourning. And so the atmosphere was amazing. And London during that 1 week was just incredible because it was very busy with tourists, but the Londoners were also kind to each other. They're generally so aggressive. They were really kind and letting people go in front of them. And everybody was carrying flowers, and men from top offices, all offices brought their people here. And the men
hoog hulle se voet op.
Harrods is open specially in December every Sunday. It has 236 departments, and really, if you have time, don't buy anything here because it's really mega bucks, very expensive. But you know, if you want to, well, buy something with Harrods written on it. Downstairs in the basement is a shop, and you can buy mugs there. There's some guy asleep there, he's really bored. Then you can buy mugs, or you can buy pens, or you can buy... You can buy things with Harrods on, you know, it's a nice gift to take home, something with Harrods on it. Thanks. Mohammed Al-Fayed, as I say, he fits everything that goes into the shop. They wrote a bad book on Diana, so he, you know, took it out of the shop. 236 departments. And Diana used to sponsor the Nutcracker suite ballet, and so he does it now, and you can see here the people from the Nutcracker.
Do the English think she would have married him?
Yeah, you probably would have. Harrods has a motto, everything for everybody. And Ronald Reagan, he was governor of California.
Thank you.
eisiau gwneud y beth yn ystod yn ymwneud. Nid ydych chi'n gwneud y beth yn ymwneud. Nid ydych chi'n gwneud y beth yn ymwneud. Nid ydych chi'n
service here, and within 1 hour of them announcing it on the radio, 2,500 people actually came to St. Paul's Church for a service within an hour of them announcing it. St. Paul's Church is built in Baroque style, and you can actually climb today. It would be fantastic. You can climb right to the top. Dome and Roman. Insurance company's house, and each time we have a new king or queen, it's proclaimed on these steps in front here on this building in front. The new king or queen, or a king and queen's died, or if England goes to war, it's proclaimed on these steps. And then to the left, as we go around this circle, to the left is the Bank of England. And the Bank of England is responsible for the gold reserves of the country, and also for the bank notes, not the coins. The coins are a responsibility of Wales, but the bank notes are responsibility of England. And you've heard maybe as safe as the Bank of England or as safe as the banker. And that's because the Bank of England, you'll see, it doesn't have any walls or doors for the first floors. Of course, there's a door for the employees to go into, but not for the public to go into. And then we go down that street where the pink taxi is. So Mansion House, the Lord Mayor on the right, in front, Old Stock Exchange, and here the Bank of England to the left. Started in 1694 to finance the French wars.
No, you need some exercise, you're playing tomorrow.
Oh, we won't walk past. We'll go to the other side and we'll walk down to the river and then you can take a picture of it.
Okay.
But this warship, it took part in the last World War. And it's called the HMS Belfast, and if you fired its guns now, the guns from here would reach Heathrow Airport. HMS Belfast, it's a museum ship. The last time it was in action was in Korea, 1962, and since 1963 it's a museum. There's seven different floors, and you can visit this warship. It's 11,500 tons in weight. The bridge that we are on, thank you. The bridge that we are on is called, as I said, London Bridge. The Americans in 1970 actually wanted to buy that bridge, Tower Bridge, and they signed a contract and said they would pay £1 million for London Bridge, thinking that over there, Tower Bridge, was called London Bridge. So the Londoners sent them this very simple bridge. They unpacked it in Arizona and found that it wasn't Tower Bridge, but London Bridge. Of course, the Londoners was now unguarded, but the bridge waits for nobody, and it was absolutely hysterical watching these policemen suddenly realizing that their president was unguarded on the other side as the bridge opened. It opens about four times a day in summer. It takes 90 seconds to open.
How do you mean open?
opens, the middle opens right up for big ships to come through. If you look to the right-hand side, that's Canary Wharf, that's the new Dockland area, and we're going to be driving just to have a quick look at that's where the new financial centre is being built, and the most modern area in the whole of Europe at this stage of the game.
In Europe?
Most modern area in Europe. We'll be having a look at that shortly. This here is, you can go up, look, they're right above us, there's a footbridge, and you can enter it here. There's a museum here, and you enter it and go up in a lift, and you can also go up to the footbridge above and also get a fabulous view of the Thames. The Thames, incidentally, is a tidal river, and it has twice a day tides, high and low tide. And sometimes it's so low you can almost walk across it. So here is the Tower of London. You can see it's got an inner wall and a...
Really nice. It's blowing that way.
So you can see how they enter the things
Yeah.
You want that?
Not yet.
That's
it. Not that.
Open the door. Open the door.
Yeah. That's what you said.
You're talking about, no? You need to partir. Thank you, partner.
No, this is normal.
Jeez, indeed.
And these lights, as I say, Yves Saint Laurent, the Frenchman, he decided he didn't like Paris, so he's sponsored the London lights instead. And here's the sign that says Carnaby Street. Carnaby Street is a pedestrian street now.
And we're now inching west, sir?
This is Regent Street. West Soho is on that side, on the left. So this is London by night. The Disney store there, Disney.
That was not alone.
This is Garrett's, this is the Queen's jeweler. This is where the Queen comes and Charles comes and does, buys all their jewelry.
Wat is dit? Een dikke vinger. Of een vinger van een knal en de ala. Kijk, dit
is een
wakkerzoek. Ik word even afgeven. Ik heb een. Ik heb een. Ik heb
een. Ik heb een. Ik heb een. Ik heb een. Ik heb een. Ik heb een. Ik heb een. Ik
So you probably don't know she said you're turkey.
I'm not sure you're allowed to drive in this lane, are you?
It's only a Monday to Saturday street shop, it says.
What?
It says Monday to Saturday.
Oh, good.
I thought that myself, but the sign says
Monday that's to Saturday.
Jockey! Come on, Olive!
Det er vores telefon. Det er vores telefon.
Kom hier aan!
Ja, ik kom niemand.
Push the boys, come on!
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Street.
En daar die boek is my kamer, links is my sister's kamer.
die vlees, hè?
Dat is ouder.
But the boy wins the league, when's they gonna break?
Go!
Where did you see it?
Down here.
Oh, right. Did you, was he training?
No, 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 no. He just came down to watch the game.
Oh, lovely piss.
Do you reckon Link is a driving vehicle?
Oh, my. My. Go, Diddy. Oh, my, Frankenstein.
Yes. He's like it. This is like it. This is like it.
He's
like
it.
He's like it, man.
Come on, I know. Wait.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, nice. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Continue!
That's what big Mark went there.
Continue! Oh.
Well.
Walter's sister, Andracht. What's her name?
Tony.
She's a mooi name.
Yeah,
she's in English.
Is he English or is he?
Yeah, she's too sure. What's he? Ink and
allemaal.
The only one
blonde.
Yeah.
Well done, well done.
What? Oh, dear.
Let's go!
Go wide!
Go for him!
You confuse an Irishman. You give him three spades and tell him to take his pick. Right, so I don't know whether I can do justice to this one. The Scottish accent, if it's a Glaswegian accent, is such broad sort of Scottish mixed with their old language of Celt that you can't, even the English can't understand them. I can't do a really thick Scottish accent, but I'll give it a go. Now, the Scottish are known for being very, very tight sort of race, and they won't part with the money. So a typical saying for the Scottish would be, "You'll never be having a sale, will you?" I was going to do a visual joke, but obviously because I'm driving now, I can't do it. So later on, I might do a visual joke about the Scottish, so if you want to remind me. And then we'll come back down into England now, and in the north, west of the country is a place called Liverpool, and people that come from Liverpool, we call them Scousers, and the Scousers are known for being a bit light-fingered. They like to pinch things. So a typical Scouse joke is what do you call a Scouser in a suit? The accused. Because the only time they wear a suit is when they're in the dock. And the Scousers talk like this. All right there, all right. Hey, leave it out, stop starting. And then over in the opposite side, we've got Geordieland. Now, Geordieland is Newcastle. Anyone that comes from Newcastle is called a Geordie. And the Geordies have a language of their own, and they've also got a culture of their own. A lot like the other regions, that's why I'm saying. Down here in London, you don't really get the mixture of the cultures, but there's a lot of different varieties of culture all over Britain with their own accents and their own way of living. People from Newcastle are quite hard race, and they don't mix well in the rest of the country. A lot of them that come down into the rest of England, they get, I don't know, a bit sort of fed up with being taking the brunt of the jokes all the time, and they get homesick, so they end up going back to Newcastle. They're quite friendly people, but back home in Newcastle you have to watch yourself a bit, especially when you're down a football match, because it can be a bit rough. And one of the jokes that you get up in Newcastle is about going to one of the matches, and if you leave your car in the street, there's a boy comes along and says, can I mind your car? And what you do is, if you pay them, you come back to your car and it's intact. If you don't pay them, then you come back and your wheels are gone. So the joke is that a little boy comes up to the car and says, can I mind your car, mister? And he says, no, you can't. And there's a Rottweiler in the back of that thing as well. He says, well, can it put out fires then, sir? Well, the Geordies speak like this. They've got a very strong accent. It's a bit like yours in a way, the way I've just done it. A bit of South African coming in there as well. Wasn't supposed to be, man. But the Geordies, they speak like this. All right. So I think that's enough for now. I was going to stand up and do this before we sort of left and introduce you to the rest of Britain. But seeing as we're driving along now, cut it a bit shorter. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that. And introduce you to the rest of the British Isles. I'll put some music on that.
Can't move after the first wave.
Come in, boys.
starting to.
Ready, blue.
Erdin!
Well played, Gareth.
Thank you.
we had a little hiccup against the odds, and with about 52 penalties against us. but this is really a great opportunity for the guys on the door to play against other players from the so what I want to do is to first to ask my captain to hand you this tie. This is a tie that the staff members wear to formal occasions. And with that also the tour brochure, one is for you guys, for the
we have a sympathy whenever a team comes to Lambeth Park, whether it be rugby or hockey or cricket or netball, we always make a presentation as well. We have a small pennant with our school badge and LPPS, which stands for Lambeth Park Boys School, and a tie for the captain. Pennant up in your school somewhere, you know, display that. I'd like to say thank you very much for the last point. It was an excellent game, very well hard fought from both sides. Unfortunately, you've run out. It was 71-5 winners. Maybe we can come across set out for a three as much as I. Thank you very much.
Ek dink ons het hierdie ouens nogal hele groepie goed geleer. Die
mees belovendste speler van die toer. Sy Oscar kan ek hom haal. Dit is werklik.
Thank you. Andy. Smile.
Wat is jouw naam?
Ronald.
Donald en?
Ronald.
Ronald en?
Kim.
Kim. Oh. Mind the gap. Aber doch ist der mal eine so. Mind the gap.
Maar mijn rechte tijd tussen die zo.
Probleem met die.
Anne was.
Ik zou ook een super te gay.
Alleen is af. Op hier.
Ja, vrouw.
Weggezien.
Ik zit niet meer in. Disposable.
Gesaggie, waar is die MP? Gesaggie, waar is die? Oh, dat is Hollywood. Waar is die weer?
Nee,
dat is twee planeten.